To survive, a cell must maintain a stable internal environment. One way it does this is by moving substances in and out of the cell. There are two types of transports, passive and active. In passive transport, substances move from an area of high concentration to an area of low concentration without using energy. In active transport, energy is required to move substances against their concentration gradient. The sodium-potassium pump is an example of primary active transport. It moves sodium and potassium ions against their concentration gradient using ATP as a source of energy. First, three sodium ions and an ATP molecule bind to the pump. ATP is then used to phosphorylate the pump, causing it to change the shape and release the sodium ions on the opposite side of the membrane. At this point, two potassium ions bind to the pump and the release of the inorganic phosphate causes the pump to change its shape again, delivering the potassium ions to the inside of the cell. The pump works in cycles. Secondary active transport is another way a cell can move substances against their concentration gradient. In this process, a Symport protein is used to move a substance like glucose against its concentration gradient. The protein takes up both sodium and glucose from outside the cell and then changes shape, depositing both substances inside the cell. Primary active transport uses ATP directly as a source of energy, while secondary active transport uses the energy stored in a sodium ion gradient to move substances. These transport mechanisms are crucial for the survival of the cells and the maintenance of their internal environment. Thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe for more animations like this.